Are you tired? Are you at a place where you're saying that, what's the point of living a life of faith? What's the point in living like this as a Christian? I don't see things coming to pass. I don't see any light. I don't see any future. Then this scripture is for you. Isaiah 40 and verse 27 says, "Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my just claim is passed over by my God?" It says, why do you say my way is hidden from the Lord? Meaning the Lord cannot see what I'm doing. The Lord does not see where I'm going and where I am or where I'm at right now. You know, the scriptures ask, the writer is asking, why do you say that? Why do you ask? Why do you say my way is hidden from the Lord? And also the second part of that verse, my just claim is passed over by my God. Why do you say that? Why do you ask that? Verse 28 says, have you not known, have you not heard, the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, neither faints nor is weary. His understanding is unsearchable. So if you're at that place of being tired and complaining and asking those questions, my way is hidden from the Lord, He does not see where I'm at, it does not see what's happening in my life, then we need to, come to that place of asking, His way, or this everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, I need to remind myself that He never faints nor is He tired. His understanding is unsearchable. Verse 29 says, He gives power to the weak, and to those who have no might, He increases strength. So He gives power to the weak. When we feel weak, when we feel that we do not have any strength to go on, and in that place of weakness, when all our utterances turn to complaints and murmurings and all negative speech, it says here that He is the one who gives power to the weak, and to those who have no might, He actually increases strength. This God, this everlasting God, this creator God, He increases strength, He gives might. Verse 30 says, even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall, but those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. So this is the promise. So if we are at that place of weakness, we need to be reminded that God is the one who actually increases our strength. If we are at that place of being weary, we need to remind ourselves, this everlasting God, He's the creator God, and He's at that place where He can renew our strength. But the key is this, that we need to come to a place of waiting, that we come and we wait on the Lord. As we wait on the Lord, the promise is that the Lord will renew our strength. So much so that we will mount up with wings like eagles, that we will run and not be weary, and we will walk and we will not faint, that we will go about doing what we are called to do. We will go about carrying out our tasks and assignments, but with a spring in our walk. We will rise up, we will soar with wings like eagles. And the key is this, that we need to wait. Now, this waiting is not a passive waiting. It's a waiting where we wait expectantly for the Lord to come through. So, just want to leave this with us. Let's wait on the Lord, and may our strength be renewed, and may we run and walk and soar. Let's pray. Father, we thank You for Your word, that as we wait on You, we will rise up with wings like eagles. You will cause us to rise up. You will cause us to walk. You will cause us to run. You will cause us to soar above our circumstances. We thank You. We give You all the praise. We give You all the glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.